Crocodile
by Nefeli.
John, Nick.
Once there was a monkey who lived in a tree beside the river. This tree produced more fruit than any other tree in the jungle, and its fruit was fresher and sweeter than the fruit on all the other trees. Every day the monkey ate this fruit and threw some into the river when his friend the crocodile came back. The crocodile and the monkey spent many hours sitting on the shore of the river and playing, and in time, they became best friends. The crocodile always took some fruit home to his dear wife, and she loved its taste and freshness. One day, she thought that the monkey's liver must taste sweet. The monkey ate this fruit every day, so its liver should be tasty. So Lady Crocodile wanted to eat the monkey's liver. She thought about it. And thought about it until she couldn't stand it any longer.
Finally, she said to her husband,
"I want to taste the monkey's liver. Please bring him home so I can satisfy my hunger." The crocodile was shocked.
"You want to eat the monkey's liver, but he's my friend. I love him and he has been so generous to us. My dear, it's impossible."
The lady crocodile became angry. She demanded that she would leave him forever if he did not bring her the monkey. The crocodile was torn apart. He loved his wife and didn't want to lose her. He loved his friend and didn't want to lose him. Why did he have to make this difficult choice? In the end, he decided to lose his monkey friend. With a heavy heart, he swam slowly back across the river and sat under an apple tree.
It's a lovely night, and I feel like going on a ride in the river. Would you like to come along?"
The monkey did not like the idea, because it could not swim.
"I don't think that's a good idea. I can't swim, and I'm afraid of the water."
"I am the king of the river. You don't have to be afraid when you ride on my back. Besides, we've been friends for a long time. What a shame if you couldn't trust me by now."
The monkey jumped onto the crocodile's back, and they sailed into the river. It was a wonderful ride, and the monkey was really happy, but the crocodile was quiet and deep in thought.
"What's the matter?"
asked the monkey.
"My friend..."
The crocodile almost burst into tears.
"My friend, I lied to you. I have to take you to my wife. She wants to eat your liver."
"Eat my liver?"
The monkey was astonished.
"Why does she want to eat my liver?"
"She knows that you eat that sweet and tender fruit from the noble tree. She thinks your liver must taste like that."
"I see,"
said the monkey, feeling that his life was in danger and thinking fast and bad.
"My friend, don't feel bad on my account. I would be honored to give my liver to your wife. But you should have told me about this before we left the tree."
"Why?"
asked the crocodile.
"Well, I always hang it on a branch of the tree to freshen it up. If you take me back to the tree, I will get it for you. Then you can take it back to your wife."
The crocodile swam quickly back across the river. When he got to the shore, he sat under an apple tree, and the monkey jumped off his back and climbed up the tree.
"Ha, crocodile! What happened today? Taught me a lesson? I will never trust you again. Never come back here. I do not want to see you again. And be a bit smart. You know that I can give you my liver. This has been a good lesson to me about trust."
This is the end of the story.